Hey everyone, welcome back to our Ratchet and Clank Seismus Let's Play. In the last episode, we was inside Clank to clear out the Technomites, and then we unlocked the location of Quadrona, which is where we're heading to in this episode, to find Auto-Destruct, which is where we'll be heading. We managed to clear Clank of the Technomites, and then escape! It's pretty fun, and different at all. That we have probably gonna buy a static barrier because I'm pretty certain the static barrier is okay, we'll come back to split beam mode. That's another ratchet. I know they said they were making clones of ratchet, but they didn't even have to see one. To make sure we break all the bolts. Because we probably need them in case of the final fight. There we go. Move the slide through. Assuming we cover as we can. We can't actually buy static barriers from them. Okay, that's how to be expected. More ratchets. They spent all of that damage. Because you know how to static barriers though, that's not really good. Continue fighting. There's multiple of me. At least I meant when they're able to take lots of damage. It would be good to buy, be able to buy the ammo for static barriers, but I It is rapid fire time. That's making you do damage. None of that, so we'll just use the PDA. Why is he not jumping against the wall? I don't know if they're in the room. Okay, there's nothing we can do with them. I assume we've got to try and jump on top of one of them. Very narrow window. Very narrow window to do this. Especially if you miss it, especially if you miss a jump. Because if you miss time you jump there, you fall straight down. Just didn't jump then. That time you'll jump. So you have to get onto it and get the hat. You've got to double jump. Can't look if you did. And then you didn't jump too early. And again. Why won't either just jump onto the jumpy wall? It's so frustrating. Then he won't jump backwards. This is gonna take a while. because he physically won't jump back off the jump wall. And I've gone too far. That time we just did jump. Back in a jump. There we go. Thought it was gonna take us forever. There's so many, it creates so many clones. There we go, we got past the clones. Oh no, grand rail section. The grand rail. But yeah, that jumping sequence has been one of the most frustrating bits of the game. Jump too early. Lucky for us, we regain all our health. Trying to have a ghost sniper, what a sniper mine up. There we go. It sounds like no, at least V2. Them butts hurt a lot. recover our health. Both rooms. Puzzles up another level. We shouldn't have to do the grind rail section again, given that we'd already done it. There's at least three waves of Ratchet. Yeah, for a barrier. There we go, that's not to be three. Now we get into the final wave of a normal. The fact that they just shot me once and it took down the shield. More ratchets. Logically, the big red button does something. The big red button opens this door. I look like I'm probably going to need to take out the ratchets. They were nourished a continue point. And a cutscene.
Ratchet, how very nice to see you. Although I'm sure you've seen enough of yourself already.
Okay, now I'm fighting myself. I assume it survived for 2.5 minutes. Logically. It survived for the next 2.5 minutes. So we can either just spend that running away. Clearly he's got an infinite supply of enemies. Yeah, so but it seems like they've got an infinite supply of enemies, so logically it seems like all we have to do is survive. For the next X amount of time. The time. So I'm going to survive and try and defeat the enemies, because A, we get bolts, which allows us to buy more ammo, and ammo is going to be useful. Okay, then the final 30 seconds. Logic has survived. Seems like great logic. Running away from a giant enemy who definitely just walked over the gap he removed. You're actually being serious. He managed to just about hit me. Managing to just about hit me, which set me down the gap. Well, this isn't fair. You managing to hit me just enough to send me down the gap. So surviving was the right thing to do. Narration, we've gotta get across this bridge. So I can't stop or get caught by him. But these things can take varying times to fall. And one hit can tend to knock me down a gap. There we go. Using our launch helipad.
Ooh, nice shooting.
Oh. Being up in the corner.
Papa, can I have a piggyback ride? You should be more careful. You almost hit me with that.
Shrunk him. Oh no, we've now got to chase him again. Okay, so we've got to destroy his shield. Okay, so we've got to destroy the shield and hit him with. Okay, so he has his little shield. Okay, well, this is gonna require the dual lacerator that we've got. Firstly, to take him out of the shield, and then. I've got no shield left, but this is looking fun. And we've only taken X amount of his health away. And his when he basically did his slappy clap, it one hits us. Do any other weapons that potentially could help us out here? Sure, if it could. I'm going to buy the Agents of Doom. Wait, let me just quickly adjust the click select. Is gonna be the case of it's gonna take quite a while because we need to make sure we don't get hit by any of his attacks. The first fight, the fight with Clank. Gives you a very false sense of security that it's just going to be very easy. Okay, so his blast does not fire. His gloves can one hit. Okay. That's why it's not. That's why it's not going well. I think our weapons are a little bit underleveled for this fight. What can we do? If I return to my ship, right, I can return back to here. To challenge also. We can return straight back to here. We're gonna teleport back here. We're gonna end the episode here, and we're gonna take on Otto next episode once I've gone and grinded the weapons to a reasonable level. So thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and until next time, see ya.